Okay, we'll now start with the financial services area. Now, as far as financial services chapter is concerned, it's predominantly factoring. That is what gets tested in exam. So we'll discuss only on the factoring side. Other side, there could be some few problems which are from RTP. None of the questions have come in exam in financial services chapter apart from factoring. Factoring is the only thing which has got tested till now in exam. Now, in factoring, you will have two types of problem. One is called as cost of factoring calculation. Second is cost benefit analysis. This area and the next area which I'm going to do, money market operation, there is good possibility that our answer may not match with institute answer because there is no consistency in the solution there. In these two areas, the consistency may not be there. I'll try to make it as much consistent as possible, but some places you will see difference depending on the kind of assumptions we take to the solution. When it comes to cost of factoring calculation, we will be using this format. This format is something which you could have seen at IPCC level. So we'll be using this format to get the effective cost of factoring. We will start with credit sales. Based on the credit period, you will get to know how much receivables is there. So I have a sales of 100 lakh. I have a credit period of 1 month. And because of credit period of 1 month, my receivables is 8 lakhs. In that 8 lakh, the factor will not be giving me 8 lakh rupees. He will say reserve of 10%, commission of some 1%, and this is the amount eligible to be lent. Amount eligible to be lent. That also he will not lend, he will deduct interest. He will deduct interest. So he lends money to us basically for the credit period which is there. So if it's a 90-day credit period, he will charge interest for 90 days and give us this amount. He will charge interest for 90 days and give us this balance amount. So I start with sales. I have a credit period in the question. Based on the credit period, I get to know the receivables. From receivables, he will deduct reserve. He will deduct commission and you get amount eligible for lending. That money also will not come to us. In that amount eligible for lending, he will deduct interest and lend us some money. Now, there are cost associated with the factoring, there are benefits associated with the factoring. Cost associated is this interest and commission. Whatever you write in working note 1 is your cost. Now, this commission or interest is basically, see what you do is you have sales of 100 lakh. But in this working note, you will calculate commission only for 8 lakhs. You will calculate commission only for 8 lakh, whatever is the receivable period. So, indirectly, my annual commission is nothing but commission as per working note 1 into 360 or 365 by the credit period. Into 360 or 365 by the credit period. Interest is also same because there you calculate only for 90 days. Here you will calculate for 365 days. In short, in this working note, all your calculation is for the credit period. Could be 10 days, 20 days. Whatever is the number of days you calculate there, when you go to working note 2, you will have to convert that into 365 days. You will have to convert those numbers into 365. Because of factoring, I'll save administration charges, I'll save bad debt. I'll save administration charges, I'll save bad debt. I save one more item called as interest. When I say what is the saving in interest is, earlier I was taking a bank loan, now I'm going for factoring. That will not come in this working note, I'll explain why in some time. That item will not come in the working note, but we will save an another item called as interest. You will get this. This is called as net cost of factoring. You will divide and write a percentage. Let's assume that is 13%. This 13% would be compared with the bank borrowing rate. Would be compared with the bank borrowing rate. And if that is 14%, you will say go ahead with factoring. If that is 14%, you will say go ahead with factoring. Now somebody says, no, I don't want to do effective cost of factoring, I want to do a normal analysis, then you will write a less here called as interest. You will deduct an item called as interest, which will be at 14%. When you deduct interest at 14%, obviously your savings will turn out to be more than cost. When you consider interest saving of 14% there, automatically saving will turn out to be more than cost and you will say that go ahead with the factoring arrangement. So what we do from an analysis point of view, if the question asks for effective cost of factoring, then I do this approach saying that I'll in working note 1, I get to know what is the amount lent by the factor. In working note 2, I get the effective cost of factoring. Some problem, in a normal arrangement, what will happen is you give a credit period of 90 days. But when it changes into a factoring arrangement, he says, I'll bring down the credit period to 70 or 75 days. Those type of problem cannot be done in this working note. You cannot do effective cost of factoring there. There we will do only cost benefit analysis. So two types of problem. One problem where they'll ask for effective cost of factoring. Second type of problem is where they don't ask for effective cost of factoring, or the problem is silent and they give you some savings in receivable, some savings in credit period. So these two types of problem, we'll see how do we factor it. Clear? Now listen, this whatever is effective cost of factoring, I can alternatively call this as cost benefit analysis. The only thing is in savings, you have to write one more item. Savings in interest cost. If you consider that also, then if savings are more than cost, go ahead with factoring. If savings are less than cost, continue with your current scheme of things, whatever is happening. So that is what we are going to do. So in one approach, if I want to calculate that effective cost of factoring percentage, if I want that number, then I cannot deduct the interest saving because I'll be comparing that percentage with the bank loan interest rate. So if I deduct that, then I cannot make a comparison. If I don't want to make that comparison, then I can save the interest cost also. I can reduce it. This is what factoring is all about. Most of the questions will fall in this format only. The two formats which I'm going to discuss. Some question or answer may not match with institute. I'm telling you now itself, it may not match with institute answer because of certain inconsistencies in their solution, because sometimes they make a different assumption. So most of the times answer would match, but some areas you will see that difference being there. Let's get into problems now. We'll see first problem where effective cost of factoring is asked. Okay, let's see this question 5. We'll see question 5 where effective cost of factoring is asked. Page 184. Page 184, question number 5. I'll straight away start with the question. Again, a format driven area, leasing, be it leasing or financial services, both are, there'll be two formats. Leasing had only one format. There'll be two formats and that is what I will be extensively using it. The only issue is at times inconsistency can be there in the solution. That is something which is unavoidable. We can't do much about it. Working note 1, computation of amount lent by factor. Computation of amount lent by factor. Computation of amount lent by factor. Particulars. Calculation. Amount. Amount lent by factor. Particulars calculation amount. Particulars calculation amount. Point number 1, credit sales. Credit sales. How much is the sales for the next year? How much? 4.8 crores and is expecting a growth rate of how much? 25%. So I'll write 600 lakhs. Credit sales is 600 lakhs. I'll do it in lakhs. 600 lakhs. 0.2 credit period. Credit period. How much is the credit period they're talking about? 90 days. Receivables. 600 into 90. The question talks about 360 days. So 150 lakhs is the receivables. This is the need I have. I need 150 lakh rupees money. He may not pay me 150. He will deduct certain items and then pay. Point number 4, less reserve. Less reserve. What's the reserve percentage they've talked about? After withholding, 10% is reserve. 10% is reserve. 10% is the reserve. Commission. All these are on receivables. Basically, technically, you are calculating everything for 90 days. When you calculate on receivables, technically, everything gets calculated only for 90-day period. Because commission would be paid on the entire 600, but for this working note, we restrict only to the 150 lakh computation. So commission is 3 lakh. Amount eligible for lending. Amount eligible for lending. Amount eligible for lending. This also the person is not going to provide. He will deduct certain extra items and then give us the amount. Amount eligible is 132 lakhs. Amount eligible for lending is 132 lakhs. Less interest. Interest is, how much is the interest rate? 132 into 16%, 90 days. All calculations are for 90-day period. And amount lent by factor. He will lend this amount once and it will be revolving credit beyond that. He's not going to give me any money. In fact, this 126 lakh is throughout the year I'll have this money with me. He will give me money on Jan 1, Jan 2 I'll do extra sales. He will give me some money for collection and lend me some money. So effectively this 126 lakhs is a permanent money available with me. This 126 lakhs will be the my requirement is 150 lakh, but he will give me 126. Balance I will have to take a loan. That's a balance part, let's not worry about it. For this 126 lakh, should I take a bank loan or I should take it from factor is what we analyze. My entire requirement is 150. I'm not worried about the balance 24 because that has to be through a bank loan only. I'm not going to be worried about the balance 24 lakh because that I'll have to take a bank loan or my equity funds. 126 lakh, should I take it from the factor or should I go for a bank loan is the analysis we are going to do. Any doubts in this? Working note 2. Computation of cost of factoring. Computation of cost of factoring. Computation of cost of factoring. Capital A costs. Commission, interest. Whatever is working note one is for 90 days, you make it into 360 days. Whatever number you have written in working note one is for 90 day period. It's for a 90-day period. These are the costs for a year, commission and interest. I'll pay commission of 12 lakhs, I'll pay interest of 21 lakhs. Commission of 12 lakhs and interest of 21 lakhs. These two are normal cost. If at all something else is mentioned, you can read it and see. But most of the question, you'll have only two costs from a factor point of view. One is commission cost and second is interest cost. If at all they give some other cost, we'll consider it. But otherwise, it's only two numbers, commission and interest. So total cost. Commission and interest, and then we have savings. Commission and interest is 33 lakh. Commission and interest is 33 lakhs. Then we get into savings. The normal savings I'm writing, first will be admin cost saving. Read the question, and because earlier we used to administer the receivable, now factor is going to administer it. What is the savings there? 6 lakhs. Bad debt saving. Bad debt saving. How much is the bad debt percentage for the company? Now listen, they're saying 20% risk with recourse. Now With recourse means the factor will not take care of the bad debt risk. Without recourse means factor is going to take care of all the bad debts. Now the company has a bad debt of 600 lakhs into 1.75%. 600 lakhs into 1.75%. So this number is 10.5. Two parties will bear this. In the past, I used to bear the entire 100%. If now also I am bearing the 100%, then there is no bad debt saving. If I bear the entire 100%, which will happen? 100% recourse. If there is a 100% recourse, I will have to bear the entire amount. Factor company, factor will bear 80% of this. Company will bear 20%, and this 80% is my saving. This 80% is my saving. Whatever factor is going to take charge, that is technically the saving for me. 20% risk with recourse means 20% will come back to me. 80% will continue to be there with the factor. Why is factor agreeing to this? Because I am paying a commission to him. I am paying some interest. So he is agreeing to take care of the bad debt risk to the extent of 80%. Balance 20% will come back to me. Balance 20% will come back to us. Any doubts in this? So bad debt saving is 600 lakhs into 1.75% into 80% into 1.75% into 80%. How much? 8.4. Apart from this, you will see a rare scenario, any other savings. These are the normal savings. These are the normal savings in a question. Any doubts on this? Total savings. Total savings, net cost, amount lent, and effective cost of factoring. Net cost is, I'm incurring a net cost of 18 lakh rupees. I'm incurring a net cost of 18 lakh rupees for an amount lent of 126 lakh. For an amount lent of 126 lakh. And effectively my cost is, this. If a bank loan comes at less than 14.77, go ahead and take a bank loan. If a bank loan comes at less than 14.77, go ahead and take a bank loan. If bank loan is at more than 14.77, then you shift to factoring arrangement. If it is at some 15-16%, I should go for a factoring arrangement. Otherwise, for the given data, what makes sense is, have they given any interest rate on the loan? No, they have just asked for effective cost of factoring. Some question, the next part, they will say, if the bank loan is at 14%, what is to be done? We will say, continue with the bank loan and no need to shift to a factoring arrangement. Any doubts on this? Any doubts on this? That will anyway be incurred. No, it's not an extra cost. When I compare from an earlier one to this one, is it an extra cost? No, it was anyway an original cost only. Just a minute. Do question 10. Do the 10th question. It's effective cost of factoring question. So try to put the data in this format. You should get to the answer. try to put the data in this format. Mostly it should be negative cost of factoring. It will turn out to be negative, but I think what in completed, I'll let you know what institute has done. Okay, they've left it at negative at least. It's a negative cost of factoring. At least it's consistent with the solution which they have given. The format remains the same. You end up using the same format. Why it is coming negative is the bad debt itself is some 4%. You may not get a factor commission at only 1.95. When bad debt is 4%, commission should have been slightly higher. The commission number should have been slightly higher. Just having 1.95% will not help. So here I don't have any choice to be taken. If they ask what is to be done, I cannot have a negative borrowing rate. So without even considering interest saving, I have an effective cost of factoring of negative 0.04%. Factor money is coming without paying any interest technically. I'm not paying any interest because that interest, whatever I'm paying, is getting saved in the form of bad debt. So effectively my cost is minus 0.04%. Effective cost is minus 0.04%. It's almost the same format. We have just put the data in that format. I've just changed the numbers and got to the same solution. This is what his institute solution is. Broadly the same thing will be there. They could have done it a little differently, but answer would match. Net net answer should match. 24.0272. They have done it in crores, we have done it in lakhs. Let me know if there's a doubt here. Effective cost of factoring is minus 0.04%. Effective cost of factoring is minus 0.04%. Any doubts in this? Clear? Okay. This is one type of problem where they'll ask for effective cost of factoring. The second type of problem is one where there will be some reduction in receivable days. If there is a reduction in receivable days, I cannot be using this format which is there. So I'll have to do that slightly different. Let's do question one. Go through question one. The current turnover is this much. They have given currently the receivables are 3500 thousands. Let's do it in thousands itself. The problem, XYZ FinCorp, a factor, has offered to manage the trade receivables. He is saying that he'll reduce the receivable period to what? 35 days. Can you just quickly tell me a number? 21300 into 35 by 360 or 365, whatever it is, 365. Okay, it's not 3500, it's a different number. The moment it's a different number, you cannot do that effective cost of factoring problem. You cannot do it in an effective cost of factoring. So this will be a slightly different computation. Clear? Any doubts in this? Working note one, directly cost benefit analysis. Working note one, cost benefit analysis. Working note one, cost benefit analysis. Cost benefit analysis, particulars, calculation, amount, cost benefit analysis, particulars, calculation, amount, capital A, benefits. You can write benefits first, cost second, that doesn't really matter, any order you follow. Benefits, capital B, costs. Benefits and capital B, costs. Okay. Now, we'll read it from the beginning. Wherever I see a benefit or a cost, I'll try to capture them. I have the balance sheet. Then XYZ FinCorp, a factor, has agreed to manage the trade receivables. XYZ expects to reduce the receivables to a current level from current level to how much? 35 days. I'll have to do a separate note calculating what is the reduction in receivables, and based on that I'll have to take some interest saving. So note one, computation of reduction in receivables. Particulars, calculation amount, point number one, existing receivables. Same analysis you will do in any question. First thing is, as an, when I see a benefit or a cost, I do this analysis. So first I saw this. Existing receivables is how much? 3,500 less revised receivables. You keep writing the unit. This is in thousands. Revised receivables. 21,300 into 35 by 365. 21,300 into 35 by 365. Reduction in. How will you use data store? In what computation? No, I want the reduction in receivables in the end. I need to know what is the reduction in receivables. So I already have the existing receivables. With debtors turnover ratio, you can get to know what is the credit period, current credit period. But in the end, I'll have to again get back to this number. What is the reduction which is happening on the receivables front? If you use debtors turnover ratio, you'll get the credit number of days the receivables is. Then again, deduct 35 and get to know what is the new receivable. So net-net, requirement is what is the reduction in the asset side. Why I am getting to know this is, if this is the reduction in the asset side, similar reduction will happen in the liability side, and which will help me in saving interest. Any doubts on this amount? Okay, now look at the question and tell me, today how are you funding the receivables? When I say how are you funding the receivables, whatever the 3,500 is there, against that you have to take some loan, you have to take something. The question would have mentioned, let's read it. The interest rate on the advance would be higher than, 2% higher than ABC currently pays on its overdraft. That is, currently I'm paying a 7% interest on my overdraft. If somebody helps me in reducing my receivable by 100,000, I'll save an interest of 7% of 100,000. Today, I'm paying 7% interest on my receivable. See, whenever there is any asset, against that there is going to be a liability. So if I have high receivable, I will have high overdraft and I'm paying a higher interest. So the first thing which happens because of a factoring arrangement is, point number one is saving in interest. There could be certain extra things, but as of now, this item I'll write. Saving in interest is 1457.53 into 7%. 1457.53 into 7%. Some 102,000 I'll save because of this factor arrangement on interest. There could be some extra payout to happen that we'll see as we proceed. But as of now, because he will bring down the receivables, I will save 102 lakhs. Because receivables are being brought down, I'm going to save 102 lakhs. Any doubts on this 102? Okay. He's also saying that he will reduce the bad debt from 0.9% of turnover to 0.6% of turnover. So he will give me a saving of some 0.3%. He's going to bring a saving of 0.3%. XYZ expects to reduce the average trade receivables to reduce bad debt from 0.9% to 0.6% of turnover. Listen, then I have two items here. With recourse, without recourse. So listen, I should have ideally done this. This is with recourse analysis. And this is without recourse. Now listen, in without recourse, I'll save the entire bad debt. In without recourse, I'll entire 0.9% will be my saving. In with recourse, the saving will be 0.3%. But in without recourse, the commission would be slightly higher. The commission is going to be higher. The question says, the commission is 0.75% if you go for with recourse basis and 1.25% if you go on a non-recourse basis. So commission can be adjusted, but here what is going to happen is, listen now, saving in bad debt, if there is with recourse, that is, I can, the factor can come back to me, then it is 21,300 into 0.3%, 21,300 into 0.3. In fact, listen, with recourse, bad debt saving should ideally be zero. With recourse, bad debt saving should ideally be zero. Here he is doing some efforts and bringing down the risk for us. He is doing some extra efforts and bringing down the risk, but ideally I'll write a zero. Ideally it should be a zero for saving in bad debt with recourse, because the bad debt risk will continue to be there with the company. Other side it is 0.9%. One is 0.3% and the other side is 0.9%. 0.3 and 0.9. Any doubts in this? We'll write the commission cost as we proceed, but as of now I have captured this bad debt part. Any doubts in this? He is bringing some more saving. What is he saying? Savings in admin cost, saving in admin cost. How much is the saving? 40. Saving in admin cost is 40. Any doubts till now? Now they are saying XYZ will make an advance of ABC to ABC of 80% of the revised book value of trade receivables. The interest rate would be 2% higher than ABC currently pays on its overdraft. Now listen. Today, this is my cost, okay? This is my cost, 3500 into 7%. This is what I've been incurring. Now, what he is saying is, he is saying, in this 80%, I'll give you. In this 80%, I'll give you at 9%. 80%, I'll give you at 9%. Balance 20%, you take it at 7% itself. Balance 20%, you manage on your own, don't come to me. Whatever I give, I'll give it at a 9%. I'll give it at a 9%. Effectively, there is a saving of this much. Some 69 lakhs will be saved. Some 69 lakhs is the effective saving. Let me know if there's a doubt in the computation. Today, I'm paying 3500 into 7%. In a factoring arrangement, I'll pay 80% of this amount at 9%. You need not write this, you need not write this. I'll give you the short way of getting an answer. This is the computation. Now what we are going to do is, extra cost on amount lent by factor. Extra cost on amount lent by factor. How much is the new receivables? 0.47. Now listen. Whatever he gives, no, 80% he will give, I have an extra cost of 2%. 80% he will give, I have an extra cost of 2%. Whatever amount you get here, no, 102 minus that amount will be that net saving which I have calculated there. So whatever amount I get here, let's first calculate this amount and then I show that computation. Whatever he is going to give me, he will give me only 80% of that. On that I pay 2% extra. Calculate this. 2042.47 into 80% into 2%. same amount will come here. Same amount will come here. In effect, I save some 69,000, and that is this number. In effect, I save some 69,000, that is this number. Old, if somebody wants to calculate the old interest cost, you calculate it. New interest cost, you calculate it. Effectively saving is 69,000. You don't save 102 lakhs. Effectively, you will save only 69,000. Earlier, 7% of 3,500. Now, 9% of some number and 7% of some number. In effect, you will save 69,350. Any doubts in this? Any doubts in this part? Can we proceed? What's the next thing they have mentioned? Okay, finally is the fee which the factor is going to charge. So factor commission, factor commission, factor commission. Now listen, in this table I don't write factor interest as an overall amount. If I have to write overall amount, then in benefit I'll have to write overall saving. Whatever you are paying earlier is the overall saving, and whatever you pay now is the overall cost. We just write the difference alone. We just write the difference. Factor commission, factor commission. In scenario one, what is the commission with recourse? 0.75. So 21,300 into 0.75%. 21,300 into 0.75%. And this side it is 1.25%, 0.75% and 1.25%. The important part is that savings and interest cost. That is the most important part. Other things should be fairly simple. The most important part is the savings and interest cost calculation. Saving and extra cost. Savings and extra cost. Put a total and see is there a net saving. Any doubts in this? So I'll go ahead with the without recourse factoring because that gives me more savings. I'll go ahead with the without recourse factoring because that gives me more savings. Any doubts in this? Any doubts in this part? Do question number 15 in the similar format. Do question 15. Do question 15. Try doing question 15 in a similar format. Question 15. Thank you.
such a rare thing.
Then let's see. Let me check what they've done in the institute answer. Are you assumed 2%? Wait. Commission. I'll check the answer and let you know what they've done on the commission front. Ideally, commission should be there. Okay, they've ignored commission in the analysis. The answer is without commission, so not logical. There should be a commission percentage, but in institute solution, commission is not there. Without commission, they have given the answer. The answer has been given without commission. Existing receivables is 540 into 12%, 365 days. One more thing, in a factoring, you will have to write your assumption. If the problem is silent, institute normally does both, saying if it's with recourse, what happens? If it's without recourse, what happens? With recourse means there is no bad debt saving. Without recourse means there is a bad debt saving. That is the only difference. Ideally, the question should make it clearer. If it doesn't make, then you write both the parts. The calculation will not change in with recourse, without recourse. Only the bad debt portion alone will undergo a change. That's all. It's not that there is some major computation difference. It's only at a bad debt level. Existing receivables, revised receivables, reduction in receivables. Okay, sorry. $30/365. It's the same format. You'll end up using the same format if there is a reduction in receivables. Any problem with reduction in receivables, this is what is to be done. Which you have got this correct. 20.42. So on this 20.42, I'll save whatever interest I was paying. Earlier, I was paying an interest of 8%. I was able to get it at BPLR. So whatever rate I was paying interest, I save that. Whatever money the factor gives, factor is going to give me 80%. Factor will give me 80%. Whatever money he gives on that, I have an extra cost of 4.6%. Whatever money the factor gives on that, I will have an extra cost of 4.6%. Ideally, some commission data should be there. As of now, it looks like this. If it's with recourse, saving of 1.25, without recourse, 6.50. I assume this is what they should have done. 1.25 and 6.50. Saving is 1.25 and 6.50. One. if you take it at 11.6 as a cost, then in the earlier calculation you have to take saving on the entire amount. Because what additionally I pay is what I have to see. So additionally payment is only 4.6. It should match with this, yeah. 1.2504. Broadly the same calculation they have done. 1.2536, 6.5036. This format you will use if there is any saving in debtor days. If any reduction in debtor days happen, this is the format. It will get used in any problem. Again, any problem where there is a reduction in debtor days, you will use this. There's another type of a problem which is what I'll discuss now. So two types of problem, one where effective cost of factoring is asked, second where you do a cost benefit analysis. Cost benefit analysis with reduction in receivables. Any doubts in this? You take the 2% itself. You will have to take the 2% commission. I will have to make an assumption whether it's with recourse, without recourse. Ideally, it will be if the commission is given, I would ideally take it as without recourse. So which one? Admin. Huh, admin will be same. Interest will also be same.
It will be savings.
Huh, savings only. Admin cost saving, interest saving for with recourse, without recourse. It's only difference at bad debt level and commission level. Everything else will remain same, extra interest, lower interest. The only difference will be saving in bad debt and factor commission. Any doubts in this? On the sales. Any doubts in this? Clear? Can we proceed? I'll just go to the last category of questions in factoring. All other problems, it'll fall in one of the two formats. The two formats, one of the two formats will get you to the answer. Let's discuss this. Go through question 9. Go through question 9. Go through the question. We'll start doing this. Calculate cost of in-house management of receivables, some proposal with recourse, without recourse, and net benefit. I'll directly explain this in the question when we do. Working note 1. Working note 1. Computation of in-house. Computation of cost of in-house management of receivables. Computation of cost of in-house management of receivables, particulars, calculation, amount, particulars calculation amount, computation of cost of in-house management of receivables, particulars calculation amount. As we read it, if we find a cost, we will write them. Currently, the sales is 1,000 crores. Its present annual cost of administration is 11 crore. So I'm first analyzing the in-house management. Let's complete it fully and then we go to the factoring part. So in in-house management, first one is administration cost. Administration cost. In the end, I'll explain you one inconsistency in the institute solution. I'll explain that in the end. Administration cost, 1100 lakhs. I'll do it in lakhs, 1100 lakhs. Administration cost is 1100 lakhs. Now listen, the company finances its investment through a mix of bank credit and own long-term fund in the ratio of 60:40. Basically, why this information is given is when you calculate interest cost, the interest cost will be 16 to 10% plus 40 to 12% for the interest cost calculation purpose. I made to calculate the interest cost, but when I calculate it, the rate will be 16 to 10% plus 40 to 12%, which turns out to be 10.8%. The interest cost would be calculated at the rate of 10.8%. Any doubts on that? Any doubts on that? We'll calculate the interest cost in some time. Point number two, bad debt. Bad debt cost. The ending of para 1 has information on bad debt. 1.5%, which is how many crores is that? 1,000 crores. So bad debt is 1500 lakhs. Bad debt is 1500 lakhs. Any doubts on this? Okay. Company has a credit policy of 2/10 net 30. What is 2/10 net 30 means? If you pay within 10 days, you get a 2% discount. Otherwise, the payment is to be made in 30 days. On an average, 40% are collected within the discount period. So 40% people are going to avail discount. 40% people are going to avail discount. So next cost is cash discount. Cash discount. 40% people will opt for the discount. Cash discount. 1000 crores, which is 1 lakh lakhs. 1000 crores into 40% people. Into 40% people. Into 2%. Some 800 rupees will go as cash discount. 800 lakhs will go as cash discount. Any doubts on this? Now, the rule is that I have told them ki you pay within 10 days, you get a 2% discount. Otherwise, you have to pay in 30 days, but these guys are paying some 70 days. So listen, as of now, my collection period is 40% people pay in 10 days and 60% people pay in 70 days. 40% people are going to pay in 10 days and 60% people are going to pay in 70 days. This will help me in calculating interest costs. 40% people pay in 10 days, 60% people pay in 70 days. How many days is this? 46. It currently takes me 46 days to collect the money. It currently takes on an average 46 days to collect the money. Any doubts on this? 40% people pay in 10 days, 60% people pay in 70 days. Now why we are calculating this is, is it 365 or 360 days? Now listen, interest cost 1 lakh lakhs into 46 days, 1 lakh lakh into 46 days by 360. Wait. This will be my debtors in the balance sheet. At any point of time, my debtors will be 1 lakh lakh into 46 by 360. Now listen, in my books, when I record debtors, I record it at cost plus profit. The debtor is always recorded at cost plus profit because sale has been done. The sale is done. So what they say in finances, if you have receivable of 1 lakh, the money blocked is not 1 lakh, the money blocked is slightly lower. And that is where some GP margin is given in the question. What is the GP margin they're talking about? 20%. So listen, this will be my receivables. This will be my receivables, but money blocked is only 80% of this. Money blocked is only 80% of this. Wait for some time. The receivables will be 1 lakh into 46/360, but the money blocked is only 80% of that. And on that amount, I have to pay 10.8%. On that amount, I have to pay 10.8%. The 10.8 was the earlier calculation which I was showing. 1 lakh is the receivables into 46/360 is the receivables stuck. On that 80%, I need funding. 20% is anyway the profit, so I don't need any funding for that. Till now, none of the question had this information. If we have such information, we have to remove that and do the analysis. So 80% is what the requirement. When I do factoring analysis, factor will not know my margin and all. He will not get to know the margin. So he will lend me money as per my requirement. But when I do analysis, I'll consider only 80% as receivables. Into 10.8%. Any doubts on this? Calculate this. You get this number? 1 minute. This is what I spend if I this is the cost of in-house management of receivables, which is 4504. Cost of in-house management of receivables, 4504. Any doubts on this? Clear? Can we proceed to the next part? Working note 2, evaluation of factoring arrangement. I'll not be doing any side of comparison. We'll just calculate the cost of factoring. Put a total of that. I have an earlier total and I have this total. I compare which is better. That's all. No concept of saying that is there a saving, is there no saving. We just compare the two cost and then decide. Evaluation of factoring arrangement. In that part 1, amount lent. Part 1 is amount lent. Particulars with recourse, without recourse, two scenarios, particulars with recourse and without recourse. I want you to do this analysis and tell me what amount the factor will lend. Credit sales, credit period, receivables, less reserve, less commission, amount eligible for lending, less interest, amount lent by factor. Institute has done this differently in different question. I would prefer to do it in this way. Our answer may be slightly different from Institute answer because they have not done, if they have done consistently the same approach in all problem, I could have told you that. So the approach is different in different question. This approach would work. To more or less it will match. Exactly will not match with Institute answer. It will not match exactly with the Institute solution. This will tell you what amount the factor is going to lend. Read it and keep filling this number. How much is the sales when you go for a factoring arrangement?
1,100 crores.
So 1,100, 1,10,000 lakhs. 1,10,000 lakhs. This format is preferable to do in any question to calculate the interest cost. Consistency is not there, but I can't help it. So this is a preferred way of doing a problem. 1,00,000 lakhs. What's the credit period the factor is saying he will bring it?
30 days.
30 days. Now listen, if there is reduction in receivables, it gets auto-calculated in the format because your interest cost will automatically come as lower. So I need not do any comparison between this and the earlier arrangement. We are not going to do any comparison. We'll just calculate the cost and then compare two costs. Automatically all benefits are considered. This into 30 divided by 360. 9,167 lakhs. 9,167 lakhs. 9,167 lakhs. What's the reserve portion? It would pay advance to the tune of 85% and 81% for with recourse and without recourse. Read it carefully. 85% is 15% reserve and 81% is 19% reserve. 15% is the reserve, 19% is the reserve, 15% and 19%, 15 and 19, 15% and 19%, 19%. Commission is with recourse is 2 and without recourse is 4. 2%. Again, this is also going to be format driven. The same format you'll use in any problem. 4%, 2 and 4. Amount eligible for lending. Amount eligible for lending. 10,000. Commission is on receivables. This is only calculated for the 30-day period. All calculation is only for a 30-day period. So that's why we calculate on receivables. When I go to the next working note, we do into 360 by 30, it gets auto-calculated for the full receivables, full sales. Interest is 20% for with recourse and 21 for without recourse. So this into 20%, how many days? 30 by 360, 127 and 118, and this is what the factor will give, 7482 and 6940. Factor will give us this money, 7482 and 6940. 74 crore and 69 crore. Any doubts on this? Okay, now listen. This is just an extra adjustment. Amount needed and amount to be funded. Now listen, what I actually need to fund my receivables is this into 80%, because balance 20% is my profit. What I need is only 80. Factor will not know how much margin and all is there. What I need is only 80% of this. Factor can end up giving me more than what I need also. It can turn out to be that he is giving me more than what I need. So I need this much, 7,334. What I need is only 7,334. In scenario 1, factor is giving me more than what I need. Factor is giving me more than what I need. So to factor, I'll pay interest, but whatever extra he gives, no, on that I'll save some interest. I'll put that in a fixed deposit. Assumption is, I'll put that in a fixed deposit and earn interest out of it. So what I need is only 7334, 80% of the receivables, and factor is giving me 7482169 40. So amount to be funded by long term funds, amount to be funded by long term funds is -148 and +394. This is the balance requirement of money. -148 and +394. -148 and +394. -148 and +394. Logically speaking, this should be the solution. I need only 73 crores, and what he is giving me 74 crores. What he gives me 74 crores. My requirement is 80% of receivables. Requirement is only 80% of receivables. Any doubts in this? Yep. What did I do? Okay, sorry. How much?
21%.
Okay. So, 400 and 148. -148 and +400. Any doubts in this? Any doubts till now? Clear? That's all. Working note 3, or part 2, cost of factoring. Part 2, cost of factoring. Particulars with recourse, without recourse, with recourse and without recourse, with recourse and without recourse, with recourse and without recourse. Okay, now listen, first cost is going to be commission. Tell me the commission percentage with recourse and without recourse. With recourse is 2%. Commission 2% and 4%. I can even take the working note 2 data, that is part A data, and then do into 360 by 30. Rounding off differences will come. To avoid that rounding off issue, I am doing it on sales. I can even do it as this commission into 360 by 30. Whatever is calculated there is for 30 days. I can do this. There will be rounding of differences. That's all. There could be rounding of differences. That's why I'm again calculating it. If there is no rounding of issue, I can end up doing that itself. Whatever you have done in working note 1 is for 30 days. Now we are doing it for 360 days. Commission 2200 and 4400. Admin cost will become 0 and 0. I don't have a concept of saving and all. I'll just write the admin cost as 0 and 0. It's auto considered. It automatically gets considered. Commission is, sorry, admin cost is 0 and 0. Admin is 0 and 0. Interest paid to factor. Interest paid to factor is, whatever is there is for 30 days, you will take it for 360 days now. So this into 360 by 30. Interest paid to factor. Interest paid to factor 1524 and 1488. Bad debt cost. If it's with recourse, the company will incur bad debts. If it's with recourse, company will incur bad debt. If the analysis is with recourse, the company has to incur bad debt. 1100 crores.
What is the bad debt percentage?
1.5%.
Bad debt cost. Any doubts in this? And the last point is interest on long term funds. What I paid to the factor I have considered. There is some funding which is not yet done. There is some funding which is yet to be done. Listen for a minute. This funding, no. You cannot take a bank loan against this because you cannot go to the bank and give, because I'll not have any asset to give to the bank. Earlier I was giving receivables and bank was giving me a loan against that. Now this entire 400, whatever you need, that has to be brought in by the promoters at the rate of our long term funds at the rate of 12%. That will be entirely brought in at the rate of 12%. So this into 12%, and ideally here I'll save some money at 12%. In one case I will have to pay certain extra amount, and in the other case I will save 12%. I'll end up saving this money. Interest on long term funds 17.76 and 48. Negative because I'm saving some money, I'm getting extra money from the factor. Okay, just listen for a minute. In case this was not there, that is 80% data is not there, then this is the amount I need. And balance will come from long term funds. On this you will calculate the interest at the rate of 12%. Because whatever is not coming from the factor will have to come in the form of long term funds. Any doubts in this? There is this cash discount where I make an assumption that cash discount is not needed. That's an assumption based answer. You can assume that cash discount is needed in factoring. Cash discount is not needed. Okay, just the last item. Gross profit on extra sales. Because you do a factoring arrangement, your sales will go up by 100 crores and this will give you some profit. That's a saving. Gross profit on extra sales, 100 crores into 20%. This is the net cost, 3576 and 3936. The net cost is, yeah. What did I do? Okay, I changed the amount. Okay. It's the same thing. There when I did a rework, I didn't change the numbers. Now based on this, I can finally decide whether to go for a factoring arrangement or to do an in-house management. Whichever gives me the lowest cost, I'll prefer that. Whether to go for a factoring arrangement or to do an in-house management of receivables. So we'll finally go with recourse factoring because that has the lowest cost. With recourse factoring, that will give you the lowest cost. Any doubts in this? Now, the inconsistency which will come in ICI solution is they will not give you the gross margin. When they don't give you the gross margin, here it is fine. The in-house management would be calculated for 1000 crores. This would be calculated for 1100 crores, but I will not have this item itself. Without having this item, they'll compare saying that for 1000 crore, the in-house management cost is so much. For 1100 crores, this is the cost. Both are not strictly comparable, but that's what institute will do. Here at least I have that margin, so I've considered that. Without having that margin in place, they'll do the comparison. Clear? With that, factoring is over. We'll take a break of 30 minutes and then I start with money market and capital budgeting.